So here's your sample.
Okay, cool.
And we can already go to the microscope. So this may be, let's start with imaging, then we will switch to
So we need to change the name because this is sand, Kerala sand.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so do you want to save this image?
Yes.
Okay.
Kerala black sand.
Okay, now we can go to a scene.
So you're using that air can to remove any particulates that might be pulled up by the vacuum?
Yes.
Right.
That's the only thing which can really harm the instrument. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I expect to see some quartz. It being sand.
At the beginning we will see some particles. Then we will find out what's quartz and what's else.
Okay, there we go. Ooh, nice.
So, which one do you want to see?
Well, are we on BSD there? Okay, so yes. This would be the heavier element, and yes. These would be the lighter elements, I guess. So, mm-hmm. I guess this must be the sand, and this must be the black sand. The black sand is white, under BSC. I think
yeah,
so.
Okay.
I think you'll find that this is a heavier element. So, yeah, let's try, well, let's move around. Let's see if we get a,
All right, if you want, you can go to that's probably too.
No, we can move out of it, can we? No. Oh, that's as most. All right,
yes,
okay.
We are already.
Let's find a selection. This is much lighter, isn't it? We had it pretty good where we started, didn't we?
Yeah.
That's a nice combination there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe there. Oh, that's a nice one. I don't know. I think this is good. Yeah.
Yes.
Right. Okay. So we can take a picture of that. Mm-hmm.
Maybe we can follow the position. Just in
that's
case.
A good idea. Yeah. So this area here allows, which is actually under the camera, so I'm going to drop off the camera for now. You can store positions here, and then if you want to go back to a particular position you were looking at earlier, then you can do that. So I'm going to turn the camera back on. Okay. Yep.
It takes the image.
Perfect.
And now we can choose the right
Okay.
measure.
And so the first one's going to jump somewhere in the middle here, probably.
Yes. So if I just select this area here.
Okay. Well, where's it going to do?
Yeah,
it's over there.
Over there. So I just stop it and we'll find the right position.
Okay. All right.
Now it works.
There we go. So some cerium and thorium. There we go, yes. So, but you can see, actually it's a, what is it? Are we excluding elements from here because
there is a gold excluded.
Okay, so, hold on.
That is one. Right click.
And include that.
So if you include it, it will be automatically.
Right, and okay, so we just, we want to do...
Just click again on the thing.
Okay, so it's not excluded now, but if it finds it, it will show it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So if we maybe check the thorium, are you completely sure?
I'm sure it's got thorium in it.
Yeah?
Certain.
Okay, that's good.
Because I have a gamma detector and I have a 99 grams of it.
Okay.
And it's huge with the thorium gamma peaks.
Mm-hmm.
So so we'll look at a whole bunch of things here and we'll do some maps as well. Okay. So the card is full over there, so we're going to have to change. We're still recording over here, that's fine. I will take the stuff off and I will... It's okay.
Just let me have a look over there.
We can work with this one.
For the minute. I think I can stop the...
Okay, Neodymium. Wow, 4.7% cerium and 1.63 neodymium. So maybe the magnetic nature of these particles is not to do with iron, but something like neodymium. Let's take a look at one of the darker particles. This is slightly darker, so we'll see what this one is. So it thinks there's some silver in here, but it could be some band overlap. Some yttrium. Cerium, silver, neodymium, yttrium. Hey. Cerium, silver, neodymium, yttrium. And phosphorus. It's a lot of phosphorus, right? So maybe, I don't know, we'll take one of the darker particles here. So the darker particles are iron rich, titanium and iron. So they are probably the black, but the other particles, if they're lighter, they could also be black, but they're the ones with the, look, you look in here, we have cerium, silver, neodymium, yttrium, and phosphorus, cerium, neodymium, thorium, cerium, thorium. Again, high phosphorus in there. And that is the misfire.
Yes.
Looking through the cowb and then seeing a bit of aluminium.
You can remove it.
Yes. So we'll delete that move measurement. Yes, because it's rubbish. So, I think, what have we got? One there. Yeah. Okay, so these ones are very iron rich. Iron and titanium.
I'm going to take a map on this. What's that? Oh, can I escape that?
No.
Oh, that's not very good, is it?
You can just stop it just over here.
Stop and delete, yeah.
And then remove it and make another one. Okay. It takes some time. No, it's...
Can you get rid of that on remove measurements?
Yes.
Okay, we'll go here. And it's going to see a lot of carbon.
Mm-hmm.
Can we exclude the carbon, right?
We can.
So let's go to carbon here and just go to exclude. And then we'll forget the carbon that it's seeing. So I think in the periodic table you've got thorium here, and it goes down, and you've got cerium here. Okay, so thorium, cerium. Mm-hmm. Wow, 5% cerium.
As long as you want to see like a small contributions, so these elements which has got a low content,
mm-hmm.
or the air has got low content in these elements, I would suggest to focus on smaller
areas. Yeah,
because then those elements can be excluded from.
Yeah, but it's interesting here, you can see that it's very homogeneous,
mm-hmm.
the phosphorus and oxygen, but the cerium is throughout. The silicon is throughout. Where's the other elements? Where's the other elements?
Yeah, okay. Just over there. Mm. So you can pull a bar over there.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so you pull this bar over here. Yeah, the thorium is spread throughout. Cerium is spread throughout.
And if you want to magnify certain elements, you can just pull...
Yeah, yeah, you can change the representational...
Colors you can change here, and you can intensify the color in the image.
Yeah.
By this bar.
Okay. So it looks like a lot of the extra weight is coming in these particles from cerium, and then obviously these iron-rich particles. I'm going to have a look at it, maybe this one. Has it done it? It's done it.
Yes.
So I'm going to take a smaller sample area. And we need to go down here. Can I move on this? I guess I can. Can I? No.
Click over here. So is this selected? And now I should be able to move. Like left click, drag. No. And wheel to unzoom.
No, not in here. I guess it's fixed.
Okay, because it's already we are not zoomed in, so that's why we cannot.
Yes.
So you have to make a new image.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, if you go here. Plus, so
no, that
go back. Yeah, go change frame. The position where you want to zoom, where you want to collect data. They're moving and.
Because the electron microscope is at high energy and it's doing stuff.
Yeah. And maybe it's maybe also because of charging.
Right, yeah.
Then they are, you know. repelling.
Yeah. Oh, look, there's a little inclusion there. Interesting, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Right, we're on the edge here. Bit of movement there, isn't there? They're alive! Yes.
That's because of charging. So we can get rid of that.
Okay.
We can...
Well, firstly, we need the energy lower, I guess. Well, we don't need. Okay. We can just increase the pressure in the column.
Sorry, in the chamber.
This is very important.
So this may reduce the charging. It will take a while. So you can see what pressures now.
I can see the charging disappearing.
Yes.
Right in front of my eyes. That's
so
great.
Probably 10 Pascal will be enough.
This is great. You can literally see it, and it's being recorded over there. You'll want this video, I think. Yeah, that's great. Look at that.
So we can restore that, or we can try to start maybe. It's up to you.
Yeah.
It will last maybe a minute. So the only result of that is that the electron beam spot is wider. Yeah. Spread.
Because
we have more molecules in the way to the surface.
Yeah.
So it's probably
how do I change the resolution of the image?
Okay, over here.
We'll take that higher resolution here. So we've got it on medium there. So we'll take really high resolution here. And
this may take like 4 minutes.
4 minutes, okay.
Right, we'll 2 minutes.
That's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Do an auto on that. And then we will take a image here. Let's see if it moves. So that really did work, removing the charting. So we've got definite sort of three areas, one here, three different types of grains. These two look like they're the same material. So in the area of India where this comes from, the monazite, which is the mineral that these sands come from, it has enough thorium to provide all of the energy for India for more than 300 years.
Wow.
If they used it in a thorium reactor. So what we're taking here is an 8K image, and was it on medium setting or something like that?
Yes.
How are we doing for time?
It's 1.
Okay.
I'm supposed to leave for one short meeting.
Okay, go. I'm just going to be looking at the elements here for a while.
Yeah. Half an hour?
Perfect, yeah. I'm going to enjoy looking at this sample.
Okay.
Yeah. Because I used to live in Kerala. I used to go to the beach where this was from many weekends. And and the locals said, it's got radioactive sand.
They don't go there.
Yeah, they go there, they're fishing, no one cares.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm not worried about this sand, I used to lie on it for years.
Yes.
Okay, so great. Yeah, you can leave me here, I'm going to need to change the... Oh, the beam NG is at 15, so...
In case anything is going to start.
Yeah, thank you.
Ow. 10.11% zirconium. That's fantastic, the sand, it really is. I'm getting rid of the carbon there. Excuse the carbon from this. $0.09 to zirconium, $0.13 to zirconium, titanium. Just amazing, isn't it? It's so mineral rich. Cerium, lanthanum, thorium. Okay, this looks like it's a similar material, but maybe it isn't. It does look similar. I wonder what this dark spot is in here. We'll find out. About that, 6% magnesium. We'll zoom into this grain. So this little particle, and we're looking up this edge here, it's not the ideal location. We'll go for a different spot in a second. And we'll stop that. Whatever you do for the first sample with this, it seems to put it in the wrong place. So we go here, remove measurement, yes. And then I will go on this one, and I'll go map. Then I'll go in there. So, Ethereum, at the moment it's reading 6.27%, silver 3.36%, and lanthanum 2.2%. Interestingly, no thorium in this particular grain at the moment. I'm going to take another map. I'm going to take it off this area here in a second. When it's finished, if it's finished. Okay, so we'll just do one point sample on the peak here, if it's going to let me. I think the silver is not silver, I think the silver is thorium. Yeah, it's a peak overlap, I think, with thorium. So now when you've got a lot of samples with a spot, it sees it as thorium. So I believe that we are looking at cerium thorium. might be the case that we have to exclude silver from some of these maps. So, exclude, and therefore it sees it as thorium. So on the BSD images, they are definitely definitely lighter particles are the thorium particles. So I'm going to zoom out of this and I'm going to find another particle. This is interesting, this one has little inclusions in it. What I might do is take a couple of other shots of this at different depths of field, and then I can merge them later. Yeah, so I'm trying to get maybe another one. So I did the top side, then the edge. Now I'm doing somewhere in the middle area, and I'll try another one or two probably to get a full depth of field on this sample. That's the plan. Ask yourself, why is there so many rare earth minerals in Terra? Is it because of the big volcanoes? Why does the volcano produce these very heavy elements? Where are they coming from? Sometimes it just takes a bit of time to get really good images. Now, apparently that is in this software, a semi-automated process to do what I'm doing here. What I might do is increase the preview resolution so that when I capture this, it does it a little quicker. Or rather, I can see it better. So at the moment, I've got the live on not a lot of resolution, maybe. tell now or you're doing it like this? What do you call this alien head? Just because it looks a bit like one. No measurement, yes. Right. So we are going to go. Yeah. And we are going to look at. Maybe. I'm going to have a look at some various places. So the light spot there, we'll see what that is. And it's not silver, I don't think. I think it is thorium. So we're going to exclude that. And I'll reassign that to thorium. And we'll have one here. So, thorium, lanthanum, iron, cerium. A lot of cerium. This area here is a lot of iron. So this could be one of our black particles. What I want to do actually is our map resolution, I'm going to put that up 480, 960 is too low, so we'll have 480. And if I do 2, what does that look? 8 minutes. Yeah. No, I'm going with that. That one. I'd like to do a much better map, but it takes too much time. So I'm going to do a map of the whole thing. And we know it has carbon in the background, so I'm not so interested in that, so I'm going to exclude that. And I'm going to exclude oxygen, we know it's got oxygen in there. Basically all oxides. So I'll exclude that. It's silicon dioxide, aluminium dioxide, and iron oxide in majority. And it certainly explains why it is magnetic. Stop that. Not adding the carbon, just to soak it. Carbon, oxygen. And I will stop that. And I will do another map when it's done. And maybe I'll do a line scan. Somewhere along there, there's a hospice. Who's that? There, it's a huge peak of stress. And where is that? There. You've got a big little sample point there. Okay, it's not getting any data because it's probably in shadow at that point there. So not so good for that particle. Okay, we will go back to the microscope. And we'll zoom out. We'll see what else we can find. lanthanum, neodymium, cerium, thorium. What a wonderful piece of sand. Phosphorus as well. It's fantastic. Oh dear. Great piece of material. There's a brighter spot here. I don't know whether that's in shadow there. Okay, so if I get rid of the oxygen here so that we are looking at oxide ore, exclude that, I get a better ratio of the elements other than oxygen. Likewise with carbon. I get rid of carbon and oxygen. So what I've done here is I asked it to exclude carbon and oxygen, so we are seeing oxides of these elements. And when you remove carbon and oxygen, you're seeing very large percentage of phosphorus, cerium, lanthanum, and thorium. This area is in shadow, so it's not the best example. So I'm going to take another map of this one, which is a similar type of material. I'm not sure it's going to tell us much more. I leave it running for longer, so I'm going to stop that one. And then I'll do another map. Here on this one. And likewise, I'm going to exclude carbon and oxygen. And so you can see we have to exclude silver as well because it sees thorium and silver. And then get rid of the oxygen. So here, excluding carbon and oxygen, we have abundant cerium, lanthanum, neodymium, and thorium. And a lot of phosphorus. I'll zoom into that particle. We'll get a map at a higher resolution, I think. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. That's no good because it's moving, it's charging and moving. I don't know if I leave it averaging, maybe it'll be okay. again. Got a lower energy. allowing me to keep on this. Okay. I guess it's going to include oxygen. Not allowing me to click on, no? It's just not allowing me to bring up that window. Interesting. Probably it was having issues there because I didn't have it with enough energy on the beam. So let's try that again. I'm going to delete this one. Center. It's not allowing me to exclude it. For some reason, this pop-up is not staying popped up. Well, that is thorium. No, it's actually identified thorium. That's okay then. Cerium, lanthanum, neodymium, thorium. Amazing. What an amazing piece of rock. It's not silver. Yes. Cesium. Look at that. Don't think that really was cesium there. Not so bad. Everything I do, it pops up that window. Any click I do, it pops up that window. So that's not good. This is thorium, it's not silver. So in this little particle here, this is the highest concentration of thorium that we have seen to date, and of cerium. not silver. Just let me get rid of it. Oh dear. Oh, that's clear. Finally. Should redo that then. That's boring. There we go. Look at that. Wow. 6.4% thorium, 4.4% neodymium, 8.19% lanthanum, and nearly getting on for 16-17% cerium. Amazing. Well, let's thought about it again, and it considers it ETH. Yes, hello. That is a lot of cerium. Weird. Okay, well, I think we're probably done. I'm going to go and look at one of the other particles there. Going back to the microscope. Zooming out. And we will auto-contrast that. And we'll turn and look at one of these particles. Ooh. I didn't want to do that. Ooh. And then it's a bit too close. Hello, my friend. How are you doing?
I'm fine. Sorry to collect. No, longer.
Hey, look at this. 16.6% cerium, 8% lanthanum, 6.3% thorium, 4.2% neodymium.
It's like a little magic particle.
Yeah.
They call it placer deposits, and it's very valuable.
Uh-huh.
And they have this problem with people illegally taking the sand, like they take truckloads of it, and they go and process it in the little factories and make these valuable elements.
Wow.
Yeah, so you can understand why. Yes. It's very high concentrations. I mean, I have a problem here, actually. If I try, it just disappears. Left or right button, I don't know. It's a real serious bug.
Maybe too many locations?
Oh, come on.
I know, it's not so
that shouldn't work like that. Anyway, I'm getting on. It's okay.
Yeah. Even doesn't reply.
No, it doesn't. It's kind of like totally frozen up in that. The rest of it's kind of working. The problem is it thinks the thorium is silver, so I have to exclude it.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway, now what's happened?
No, you are taking a new image, so you have to choose a new location.
I have done. Oh no, this is fine. This is what I want. It just doesn't put the image in there until it's there, until you click on it.
Slightly shifted, probably.
Maybe.
Actually,
no, that bug has stopped happening. I think you need to talk to your programmers.
Yes. It's your business program issue.
Yeah, definitely it's programming issues, yes.
So hopefully next version will solve.
Not hopefully. It has to. You can't use it reliably when you can't select.
Yes.
You know, at the moment I've got it. Look, if I click here.
It even doesn't reply.
No.
Okay, we can then.
It's fine, okay.
So you still record the video?
Yeah.
So let me then, if you can send me clip, short clip.
It might be that they're taking some sort of screen registration or I don't know, but it's clicking on oxygen, it's fine, it's doing that. And then it doesn't matter so much.
You click exclude, over here.
Oh yeah, that's now. Okay, right, but.
Maybe you can try it now. So you want to exclude, oxygen?
Yeah, exclude oxygen so that I can get their oxides off.
Mm-hmm.
And so I can see the relative ratios. So this is like, they actually use this SEM to make titanium.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you have toothpaste or stuff, they make, the titanium comes from there.
Okay.
And it's like, you can see in some of the particles, it's a very high concentration of titanium.
Yes.
But also if you look up here, look, very high concentration of zirconium. Mm-hmm. This is just magic sand.
Yes.
it has all of the really important technological elements. It's just incredible.
Have you had a lunch?
Not yet, no.
So there are two options. We have some something to eat. In the fridge, can you bring it?
Oh, okay. What have you got in the fridge?
It's Swedish cake.
That's fine, yeah.
Or we can go across the street, there is a restaurant.
Are they? I don't know, if I do that, then I won't achieve what I want to achieve today. Maybe I think the Klavichki is better for me. This looks great. So I'll show it on the video here. This is traditional Czech food here. It's very, very nice. There we go. Yummy. You can go up the road, but I think maybe I need to change this for the other samples.
Yeah. So let's do that.
Yeah. Let me just do one area sample on this.
Yeah.
Because this is the
iron-rich, titanium-rich particles. So,
so now we have to.
I'm going to do a map. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe first stop that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, it'll be finished quick actually.
And then you should write down project title.
Yeah. Quite amazing. So a lot of the weight of this sand is coming from zirconium, iron, zirconium, iron, but with the other grains, cerium, lanthanum, thorium and neodymium, they're all really heavy elements.
Yeah.
So I guess that's where it's coming from. Is that the cleaner of examples?
You're still not having definitely make use of Elgast.
Thank you. Okay.
Ready?
Yep. So I need to save this, right?
Yes.
Expand.
We'll be on the desktop.
Yeah, okay. Hours, 19
mm-hmm.
minutes. But
no.
Almost nothing.
So it stores everything and doesn't compress it. Because compressing.
No, it is. It's just using the NVIDIA graphics card.
Okay.
So that's doing all the compression. So the CPU, all that's doing is it's moving the data from the USB to the graphics card.
Yeah.
It probably is a direct memory access, probably. It just says you go there and then that's just running the screen.
Yeah.
And the GPU's doing most of that as well. Right, so next we are going to, I need to clean off the stuff from this memory card.
Mm-hmm. So that I can then use this.
Because it's beautiful today, right?
Yes, it is. I have to still
do
something.
Oh.
So I have already changed my plans for the afternoon.
Have you? Mm-hmm.
I wanted to prepare some filter samples for next week, but I will do next week.
Okay.
Mm. 6 minutes.
Mm. So I think that's safe, so you can shut it down if you want. Shut this.
You mean the project?
Yeah.
take the sample out. But you still want to record how you prepare the sample, how you put it in real.
Well, I'm recording over there, so the stream is continuous. Mm-hmm. But this will finish copying in 5 minutes. So maybe I should move that camera so it's just pointing there. I just need to move this side and leave it copying.
What? It's yours. You can keep it as an interesting sample,
yes.
Right?
Yeah.
You don't have many samples that have thorium, cerium, neodymium.
Not really.
So
I was just like, nice thorium. Oh, maybe fitting, wrong fitting of the spectrum.
No. I knew it had thorium in there before. The sand was looked at in the 1970s,
mm-hmm.
And obviously. They know it has a lot of thorium down there, but the local fisherman told me this particular beach was quite radioactive.
Mm-hmm.
And I got this sand in 2017, but I had no means of testing whether it was radioactive. So
yeah,
but since then I've got Geiger counters and I've got gamma spectrometers,
uh-huh.
And a couple of weeks, like a week or so, 2 weeks ago, I put it on there and it was like. And so I left the spectrometer on there, and I see all the bands for thorium.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. And also,
good that you know what's in there. Otherwise, it's maybe sometimes a little bit tricky because it's a completely unknown sample to me.
Yeah.
I really have to think about, okay, is it right? Is it fitting the spectrum right?
Yeah.
Is
there I could see it was seeing silver, and it wasn't seeing silver. It's because there was a band overlap between silver and thorium.
Uh-huh.
And I already knew it had thorium in there because I could see the gamma rays from the decay of the thorium decay chain.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah. So that's one of your most interesting samples. you need to note it, right?
Well, if I can find it later on.
Well, you need to note it, right?
Yes.
So, thorium, zirconium, iron, cerium, neodymium.
Iron.
Yeah. Great stuff.